Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Vibha Khanna and in this video we are going to talk about confocal microscopy. Now, confocal microscopy is another type of optical microscopy itself. Confocal basically refers to having the same focus. Here, the focus is the same as we will see in this particular video, that basically the object and the image that is formed, they are confocal. Because of this confocal image and object, the out of focus information is eliminated by means of a pinhole situated in front of the image plane. So this confocal microscopy is also known as the laser scanning confocal microscopy or the confocal laser scanning microscopy, that is the LSCM or the CLSM. This confocal microscopy is basically a modification of fluorescence microscopy. It has got many advantages over wide field optical microscopy. The disadvantage of fluorescence microscopy, that was the researchers they were coming across, was this fluorescence microscopy has excess of background noise, background information, that is not lack of focused information of the point that we want to record. Apart from that, this confocal microscopy, it can also be used with thick specimens or sections. That is, we need not have thin specimens, as is the basic requirement of most of the other optical microscopy techniques. This laser scanning confocal microscopy, it is used in this. This confocal microscopy is basically an advanced form of optical microscopy itself. The advantage of this confocal microscopy over this wide field optical microscopy is that it eliminates or reduces the background information from the focal plane. It is a modification. This confocal microscopy is basically a modified form of fluorescence microscopy. The problem with fluorescence microscopy was, or the rather the disadvantage of fluorescence microscopy was, that all the particles that emit fluorescence, all that fluorescence was captured and the image obtained was not a sharp image. It was something very blurred. So confocal microscopy is used to obtain very sharp images. And for this also, the specimens, the immunofluorescence tagging is done to focus or to demarcate the exact focus point in the specimen that we want to study. Now, this confocal microscope, it collects serial optical sections from the thick section itself. That is, multiple layers of specimens, they can be imaged using confocal microscopy. For the purpose, lasers used, they are high intensity monochromatic light sources, the source of light. Now, these lasers, they are basically designed to produce and amplify this stimulated form of light into intense and focused beam. What we were talking about was that with the help of confocal microscopy, we are able to image the exact spot that we want to go in for. And this is achieved by using laser as the optical source. Laser word itself means it is basically derived, it is an acronym for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiations. So it is very high intensity and it can be focused to different depths of the specimen because by adjusting the intensity of the laser used. So the basic design of the confocal microscope, here I'm going to use the pointer option. So in this confocal microscope, there's a source. This is the source of the laser beam, and in front of this laser beam is a pinhole aperture filter. The purpose of this pinhole aperture is to focus the pinpoint the light that will be incident upon, yeah, that will fall upon the specimen that is placed over here. This laser beam, it passes through the pinhole, it is focused, and then it is reflected by this dichromatic mirror. A dichromatic mirror is present in the form of reflector. Then here is the objective lens, because we need to, what our purpose is to magnify the image, and here is the specimen. This specimen is basically having different fluorophores that we will be using, and apart from this, when light is emitted back, it passes through this barrier filter and again another pinhole aperture or pinhole filter is placed in front of this photomultiplier detector. This photomultiplier detector is essential because it captures very weak signals also, because this pinhole aperture, it will filter off all the noise. That is, by noise we mean that all the rays except for the rays emitted by the specific segment or specific point that is our focus. So advanced feed components of modern confocal microscopes are, first, use of laser as the light source in order to detect even the weak signals. A digital camera, a photomultiplier detector, that is PMTs, they are used, and the images that are taken by this, they are then analyzed using microcomputers. This microcomputer, it also is used to focus the scanners, the mirrors, because as we will see that multiple in all the directions, in all the three directions, that is X, Y and Z, in all the three dimensions, images, they can be recorded using this particular confocal microscope. Now, what is the principle of confocal microscopy? Here too, we are using fluorophores. So, as we had seen, or rather as we know, that fluorescence is the phenomena in which the molecules, when they absorb light, they get excited. These fluorophores, they get excited, and at their high energy level, they high energy state, they emit light. This light is given out in the form of fluorescence, and it returns back to the ground state. So the incident light, in case of confocal microscopy, we will be providing in the form of laser beam, and the fluorophores, they will get excited. When they return back to their ground state, they will emit light of different wavelength, of lower energy, of higher wavelength. And this will be captured or detected by our PMTs, the digital camera, the detector part. So when this is the laser beam, when this is the point of the specimen, that is the focal region that we want to image in particular. Other regions of the specimen also, they have got this fluorescence they have been tagged with this immunofluorescent molecules. So when laser beam, it falls on these different fluorophores. Here is the laser beam, the blue one, and this green one, it is the emitted light. This emitted light, it falls on the objective, and before reaching this detector, only the part of the emitted light that will pass through this pinhole filter, it will be detected by this detector. Rest of the emissions or emitted light, they will be blocked. So here, as we can see, that the laser beam that is incident upon our point of focus, when this is emitted, when it results in the emission of the fluorescence, only this fluorescence is focused, because this detector, or rather this pinhole filter, and this point that we want to image, they are confocal to this objective. So here is the ray diagram of what we are talking about. Here is the source of light, that is the laser beam. The laser beam emitted, it passes through this confocal pinhole filters, and this focused, now the purpose of this particular pinhole filter is to focus the laser beam, focus it on the dichromatic mirror. This dichromatic mirror, it reflects these laser beams and on this objective. As we know that these rays, they will be focused on the foci of this lens, and this becomes the focal point. So the fluorescence emitted by this point will be recorded by the detector. So this is the part that laser beams are used to excite the fluorophores of the point of concern or of the point of interest. Now what happens at this point of interest is the fluorophores, they emit fluorescence. When light energy is emitted from a foci, it will move out, and this objective will again focus it on this point. Now at this confocal point, confocal having the same foci, the foci of this point of interest and of this particular pinhole filter that is placed in front of the detector, it is the same. This is the basic principle of confocal microscopy. So now the rays, the emitted rays, they are going to reach this point from all over the specimen, because fluorophores, they are present with all over the specimen, but only the emissions from the point of interest, they are going to pass through this pinhole aperture and will be sensed or captured by a detector. So, using microcomputers, the entire specimen, it can be scanned point to point in all the directions, the x direction, the y direction, and even z scanning is possible. Z scanning means that this optical axis, the distance between the sample and the objective lens is changed in the Z dimension. So, at every point, same thing happens. Whichever is the point of focus, the image will be captured by the detector of that particular point of interest only. And in this way, we are going to have a series of images, many images together. These images, they will be more focused. They will be very sharp. They won't be the blurred image that is generally obtained using the fluorescence microscopy, because in case of fluorescence microscopy, all these emissions, they are detected by the detector because it lacks this pinhole filter. So, in case of confocal microscopy, the various images of the specific points that are obtained, that are recorded by your detector, they are combined together and they give the image of the specimen that we are concerned about. And since even Z scanning is possible, so we may even obtain a three-dimensional image using confocal microscopy. Now this, that is the area in focus which are highlighted on the image captured with the confocal optics. This process is known as the optical sectioning. That is, with the help of confocal microscope, optical sectioning is possible and even Z scan is possible. And this results in the formation of a three-dimensional image of the specimen that we are interested in. So, we see that this confocal microscopy is basically an optical microscopy in which laser beam is used so that focused light is incident on the point of interest. And from that point of interest, the fluorescence that is emitted, it will be detected by confocal filters placed in front of the detectors. This will stop or reduce or rather eliminate all the noise or all the extra emission from the specimen, and we will get a very sharp image. So, this is the benefit or advantage of this confocal microscopy. Thanks for a patience listening. Thank you.